Hi everyone, it's Vignesh from Code Android. Today we are going to see about intent. If we need to open any other activity, we need to use intent. Intents are used for starting an activity, starting a service, and launching broadcast receivers. There are two types of intents available: explicit intent and implicit intent. In explicit intent, we will give the destination class name explicitly, so the exact activity will be launched. But in implicit intent, we will specify the destination using a string, so it can suggest one or more activities. Let me give an example. If we need to send a message to anyone, we can use SMS, WhatsApp, or any other messaging services. In that case, if we use implicit intent, user can select required messaging application at the time of sending the message. Also, using this intent, we can send the data between activities. Here, in implicit intent example, we are sending the message as intent parameter. To demonstrate this, I am creating an application with default configuration. Open activity underscore main.xml. Change the root layout to linear layout and adding orientation as vertical. Adding two buttons for launching explicit intent and implicit intent. On click of explicit intent, launching the same activity and killing the old instance using finish method. Otherwise, how many times we are clicking on the button, that many main activity will be launched. So, on press of back button, we can't go to home screen or all apps screen. To avoid that, I am calling finish method after launching the same activity. You can do the same thing by setting flag without calling finish method. For this tutorial, I am going to use finish method. On click of implicit intent, we are going to send the message using action send. Setting the extra text as code Android. And setting the type as text plain. Now, launching this intent using startActivity method. Let's run the application. On click of explicit intent, same activity is launching again. You can see on click of back button, the application got killed. Let's try implicit intent. Once we click on implicit intent, it's showing the available application that can handle text messages. Selecting message and selecting the receiver number. You can see the message is added as message content. This emulator doesn't contain any messaging application, so it's not showing in suggestion. If you install the same application on your device, and if your device contains WhatsApp or Messenger, those things will come up in this list. So you can share the messages using those services. That's all for this tutorial, guys. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. If you have any doubt, please put it in the comment section. I will try to answer it. Hope you like it. I will see you on my next video. Have a good day.